As the debate continues about the nation's new health reform law, in the courts and on the campaign trail, the Kansas Health Institute has asked some experts to share their views. These interviews with providers, public officials, and people on the business side of healthcare are intended to help Kansans better understand how the law will affect them and help them sort fact from fiction and policy from politics.
Polls do tell us that people really do not understand what's in the law. Some of the major misconceptions are around the employer requirement. There's a rule in the law that requires large employers, and here large means more than 50 full-time workers. Those employers are required to offer some sort of affordable and adequate coverage. But what we know from the most recent polls is Americans think this applies to all employers. A fair number of Americans in the most recent poll had a sense that there were new rules about pre-existing conditions, that insurers were going to be required to take you on even if you had an illness. People are very aware of the individual mandate. They know there's going to be a requirement that they have to get coverage in 2014, but they don't know the flip side, which is there will be new ways to get that coverage. There will be health insurance exchanges and federal assistance to pay for it. There's a shortage of information on what the potential positives could be. So it's really important that we do arm consumers with the information that they need. We do think the law would likely meet its objective of covering people who haven't either been able to afford coverage or haven't had a way to obtain coverage. A large portion of those are going to be low income enough to qualify for Medicaid when the Affordable Care Act's Medicaid expansion takes effect in 2014. The other big chunk of folks that are uninsured will qualify for what are called premium tax credits under the law. It's just a federal payment to help you pay for your coverage. So we know almost 90% of the uninsured are going to have some type of federal assistance or federal help to get coverage. And then the other piece is the people that are getting their coverage in the individual market. They might just have a new option now through this health insurance exchange that would be a little bit easier to use. A health insurance exchange is an online marketplace where people can go to purchase coverage. You go in, you type in a few parameters about yourself, maybe your income, the type of insurance that you need or are looking for, and then it sort of spits out options for you. If you do qualify for federal assistance to pay for your coverage, it will be calculated for you and it would tell you right there on your screen, this is what you would be expected to pay. This is what your federal credit would be. So it's really intended to be just one-stop shopping for insurance. It's also the place where people who are eligible for Medicaid would find out that they're eligible for Medicaid and be enrolled in a Medicaid plan. I think overwhelmingly we know the congressional delegation and our state elected officials are not very enthusiastic about this law. There's some pretty firm opposition. To actually have people required to have health insurance is a big change for us. And to have the state told to expand its Medicaid program to such a wide extent, I think is also sort of uncharted territory. But I think a lot of the opposition really comes maybe from fear or from confusion. We don't know what it's going to look like in 2014 or 2019 or in 25 years from now. So I think there's a lot of valid skepticism and concern about what this is going to look like. But I think some of the fear comes from confusion about what's actually in the law as it's written.